Hi guys! Welcome sa Zip Line. In this video, ay tuturuan natin yung series natin on system of linear equations in three variables. So, here we have three equations. 2/3 x plus 1/2 y plus 5z equals negative 2. 6x minus 1/4 y minus 7z is equal to 15. And negative 8x minus 3z is equal to negative 9. No? So, anong pagkakaiba nito dun sa mga previous videos natin? Dito sa equation na to meron tayong fractions, no? And pangalawa, meron tayong equation na dalawa lang yung variables, no? So pag ganito yung situation, pag meron kayong nakitang fraction, kailangan lang natin tanggalin yung fraction para mas madali, no? So for example, sa equation 2, we have 6x minus 1/4 y minus 7z is equal to 15. Pwede natin tanggalin yung 1/4 by multiplying both sides of the equation by 4. So, pag minultiply natin yung equation 2 by 4, we have 6 times 4 is 24. So, magiging 24x minus yung 1/4 y times 4 is just y. And then, yung minus 7z, that's times 4, magiging minus 28z is equal to 15 times 4 is 60. So, paano naman pag dalawa yung fractions katulad nung equation 1? So, ang gagawin nyo ay kukunin nyo yung LCD ng mga fractions. So, yung LCD ng 2/3 tsaka 1/2, that's 6, diba? Tapos, pag nakuha nyo na yung LCD ng mga fractions, i-multiply nyo rin yung both sides of the equation by the LCD. So, here, we multiply both sides of the equation by 6. So, magiging 6 times 2/3 x, that's 4x, plus 6 times 1/2 y, magiging 3y, and then 6 times 5z, that's 30z, and then 6 times negative 2 is negative 12. Yung equation 3 ay same lang siya. Wala tayong babaguhin, no? 8x minus 3z is equal to negative 9. So, yung gagawin natin, this is equation 1. This is equation 2, and this is equation 3. Now, notice that we have an equation with two variables. No? Ibig sabihin, dapat kukuha tayo ng isang equation na x and z rin yung maiiwan para ma-eliminate natin. Ibig sabihin, ang kailangan natin gamitin ay yung equation 1 at equation 2 with the goal of eliminating y. So, kung mapapansin nyo, meron tayong plus 3y dito, meron tayong minus y dito. Ano ang gagawin natin para ma-eliminate natin yung y pag in-add natin? Ibig sabihin, i-multiply natin to ng 3, di ba? Kasi magiging plus 3y, and then ito magiging minus 3y. Meaning, we have equation 1 plus 3 times equation 2. So, yung equation 1 natin, kukopyahin lang natin. We have 4x plus 3y plus 30z is equal to negative 12. And then, imu-multiply natin yung equation 2 by 3. So, 24x times 3, that's 72x. And then, yung minus y times 3 natin yung y, magiging minus 3y. And then, minus 84z, that's equal to yung 60 times 3, that's 180. So, pwede na natin i-add yan. Lagay natin yung plus sign. So, ang 72x plus 4x, that's 76x. Yung plus 3y tsaka minus 3y, mawawala na yan, makakancel na. And then, we have 30z plus negative 84z, that's negative 54z. So, magiging minus 54z equals ano ang negative 12 plus 180. That's 168, no? So, this will be our equation 4. And notice that equation 4 and equation 3 have the same variables, no? X tsaka Z. Meaning, we have to eliminate one of the variables. So, ano napapansin nyo? So, yung X, we have 8 and 76 as numerical coefficients. And ito naman, meron tayong 3Z, tapos meron tayong 54Z. Alin kayang mas madaling i-eliminate? Mas madaling i-eliminate yung Z kasi yung 54 is divisible by 3. So, meaning, we just multiply this by a number para siya maging 54, and that's 18, no? Pero dahil pareho silang minus, maganda kung i-multiply natin to ng negative para maging plus 54z yung magiging result. Para pag in-add natin siya sa minus 54z, then their sum is 0. Ibig sabihin, equation 4 plus negative 18 times equation 3. Okay? So, sulat muna natin yung equation 4. We have 76x minus 54z equals 168. Oh, by the way, nakalimutan natin may negative pala to dito. Kasi meron tayong negative dito. Okay, so that's negative 8 times negative 18, which is 144x. And then we have plus, so that's 54z. So that's equal to negative 9 times negative 18 is equal to 162. So we add this. Ang 76x plus 144x, this is 0, carry 1. This is 2, carry 1. It's 220x. And then yung minus 54z plus 54z is 0. And this is equal to 0, carry 1, that's 3, carry 1. 330. So 220x is equal to 330, which means that x is equal to 330 over 220. If we divide by 10, that's equal to 33 divided by 22. And if we divide by 11, that's 3 halves. Okay? So meaning x is equal to 3 halves. Alright, so nakuha na natin yung x. Pwede tayo mag-substitute sa equation 3. So this is negative 8 times 3 halves minus 3z is equal to negative 9. Ano ang negative 8 times 3 halves? That's negative 12 minus 3z is equal to negative 9. Negative 3z is equal to negative 9 plus 12. Negative 3z is equal to 3. And dividing both sides by negative 3, we have z is equal to negative 1. Y na lang, no? So we have 2/3 x. Ang x natin ay 3 halves, no? Plus 1/2 y. And then plus 5z. Ang z natin ay negative 1. Equals negative 2. So ang 2/3 times 3 halves is 1. And then plus 1/2 y. Plus negative 5, no, or just simply minus 5 is equal to negative 2. So meaning 1/2 y minus 4 is equal to negative 2, which means that 1/2 y is equal to negative 2 plus 4, which is equal to 2. 1/2 y is equal to 2, which means that if you multiply both sides by 2, we have y is equal to 4. So ang x natin ay 3 halves, ang y natin ay 4, at ang z natin ay negative 1. Alright, so that's it. Sana nag-enjoy kayo sa ating tutorial. Maraming salamat. Sa susunod na video, isa-summarize na natin yung ating natutunan dito sa System of Linear Equations in 3 Variables. See you!